Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13.3.1 has been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, along with my iPad with iPadOS 13.3.1 on my 2018 12.9-inch iPad Pro. So I wanted to talk about how it's been for me, how it's been for you, and then we'll take a look at the YouTube community poll, some stats, and then some of your comments. So if you'd like to jump to a specific point in this video, I always link the time codes in the description, so check those out if you'd like to jump to something you wanted to see, such as battery or something like that. Now, the first thing is I've had a couple little strange issues with this particular update. For the most part, it's pretty good. But yesterday, as I was using it, I went into settings, and then all of a sudden, this screen completely froze. I couldn't do anything with settings. I could go home, but if I went into settings, it was frozen. It took a minute to unfreeze, kind of like it did a while ago when we had those issues, and then it worked fine. I then went into notes to actually type this and remember it, and notes actually crashed as well. So now it's working fine, but that's been kind of a little bit of an issue. Now, as far as one other issue I've had, it had to do with YouTube and double audio. So maybe I'm listening to a video that I'm watching, could be anything. I could tap on my subscription feed or whatever, listen to a video, and it would play the video next to it, not the video I'm watching. And then all of a sudden it would overlay both on top of each other. So I might be watching one video, but hearing both of them from the one before it. It was really odd. And one of you have said you've had the same issue as well, but those three things are the major issues I've had with it. For the most part, it's been really good. Performance is great, other than the lockup there. The frame rates have been smooth. I've had no issues with that. Now, RAM management, I've had no issues with whatsoever. So if I go back into YouTube, it's not reloading. And I find that I can load about 20 apps without it refreshing. So I could go into music, then maybe go to home, then go back, then go to the app store, wait for it to load here, then go to camera, and on until I've loaded 20 of them. And the apps that I've loaded in the background don't seem to reload most of the time. Occasionally they will, if it's been a while, but most of the time they seem to be working well, and multitasking and RAM management is much, much better. And quite a few of you have said the same thing. Now, another issue I had was with Wi-Fi. I haven't really had many issues with Wi-Fi or anything, and LTE and Wi-Fi connectivity in general have been fantastic. So for example, if I turn off Wi-Fi, go to Safari, go to Apple, for example, it's loading right away. I didn't have to try and turn on airplane mode and refresh the connection or anything. It seems to be working fine. I've had no issues whatsoever, thankfully, on this particular update. So all of those things are working well, but I did have one time when I came back to my office and all of a sudden it wasn't connected to Wi-Fi. I had to go into my Wi-Fi and manually connect it. Since then, I have not had the issue, but I had to connect to Wi-Fi and then it worked fine. So I'm not sure what was going on there, but there was a little bit of an issue. Now, as far as battery health, updates do not affect battery health. I know a lot of people are saying my battery health went down. Well, that's just because after you install an update, it actually rechecks the physical battery health of the battery itself in the phone. So if your battery health went down, it's because of that. You won't see an improvement in that normally without replacing the battery. You might see a 1-2% variance from time to time, but it takes replacing the battery to bring it back up to 100%. Now, my battery life has been pretty good, good enough that I haven't really noticed it. And yesterday, you'll see I had 3 hours and 15 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 32 minutes of screen off time. And in that 3 hour and 15 minutes, I only used a quarter of my battery. So you'll see here's the usage, 0-100%. And I didn't recharge it in any of that time. So if you kept using the phone and brought it to 100% usage and then tried to recharge it, that sort of thing, I would have gotten over 12 hours of screen on time. So battery has been really good for me. And the majority of you have said battery has been good as well. So I went through all 300 plus comments in the YouTube community poll and took out all of the things people had said about battery. And 53 out of 74 of you said that it was good. So 53 said battery was better, 21 said it was worse, and a lot of those people commented right after the update. And if you commented right after the update came out and that sort of thing, you're going to have poor battery, as it has to do a lot of background processes. So all of those things go on in the background. Usually the first day or so you have poor battery, and then after that you have better battery. So 53 said good battery, 21 said it was worse. There were a few other people that mentioned battery, but I wasn't sure what they were saying, so it was hard to understand. Now, with iOS 13 and iPadOS 13, on my iPad, I've had zero issues, zero lockups, zero problems, nothing at all. The only problem at all I've had is with the YouTube app specifically. It kind of drops Wi-Fi speed for some reason. If I go on my iPad and go to Safari and go to the same video, I don't have an issue. So it's specific to the app, and YouTube needs to update the app, and then the connections will stop dropping. Otherwise, no issues whatsoever. I know some people were having touch response of issues on this, but I've had no issues. Now, as far as issues you've experienced or things you've mentioned, battery, I already talked about how you said it was mostly better, most of you anyway, and most of you said RAM management was better, so there's less apps closing in the background. But some of you are saying notifications are still not coming in properly. Now, Apple was supposedly supposed to fix this with this particular version of iOS 13.3.1, and unfortunately, those push notifications sometimes still aren't coming in on Wi-Fi, according to some people. Now, the number one complaint of anything is that the phone has issues with mail still. So you might have the number one here, you go into your email, and it's not there. I actually haven't had this issue now that this update's out, but many of you are saying that if it shows one or two or three email that are new here and you go into your email, it takes a while for them to actually show up. So some people are having that issue. And the number two problem people were saying they were having was with the phone getting hot. Now, it's normal for it to get a little bit warm when you're doing process intensive tasks. So you're using that processor a lot, maybe working on video or something like that, or playing a game. But if you're just using it and maybe going to Safari, going to music, it really shouldn't be getting warm. And people were saying that it's getting warm. So in order to fix that problem, normally what you want to do is a hard reboot. So if you're on a phone with Face ID, just volume up, volume down, press and hold the power sleep wake button and keep holding it until the phone completely reboots. That usually will fix the problem. If you don't have a Face ID phone, you can reboot it. Just look up hard reboot. I have some videos on that as well. Hard reboot the phone, that usually fixes that problem. I'm not sure what's causing it, but that usually just means that the processor is doing something that's intensive. And that, of course, will lead to bad battery because it's pushing a lot of power to the processor. Now, also someone mentioned that they had hard lockups, similar to what I had with settings, but it completely froze the phone. So they had to reboot and it wouldn't work. Another person mentioned that they had app crashes from time to time. Not a lot of people are mentioning that. And then a couple people said they had Wi-Fi disconnects. I heard that from three people. So three people were saying Wi-Fi was disconnecting. Sometimes when Apple pushes an update, it tweaks the Wi-Fi settings, and then the router that you're using doesn't like it, and that router needs to update theirs to comply with Apple. So it's hard to say what the actual cause is, but we've seen this for years going back with iOS 4 or so, or 5, where I was actually working in a networking operations center. They updated the app and everybody's Wi-Fi just wouldn't work if you had a Cisco router. So they've had issues like that over time. It seems to be maybe something going on with that now. And then finally, there are a couple odd camera issues that people were having. They'd open the camera and say that the camera was blurry. So a reboot fixed that. Why that's happening, I'm not sure. So this update is not without bugs, but for the most part, the majority of you said it was really good as far as battery, performance, RAM management, and just overall usage. Quite a few of you just said it was great, and a lot of you didn't comment as well. But if you did comment and you put what issues you had, here's how many times things were mentioned, either good or bad. So you have battery and RAM management and things like that. And then as well as that, here are the devices listed that you used. So these are all of the devices that you mentioned that you were using. If you didn't say what device you used, I couldn't put the number here. So that's it for that. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now it's been about a day or so since I started the YouTube community poll, and there were 9.7K votes. So 9,700 votes. So I really appreciate that. And 54% of you have said that it's great. 3% have said it's terrible. 11% have said okay, but some bugs. 21% of you haven't updated yet, or maybe you're just on an older device that has iOS 12, and 12% of you use Android. So I appreciate you commenting or voting, even though you don't have iOS and it's not related to that. Now let's take a look at some of the comments at this current time. There's 303 comments. I've read every one of them. That's how I made all that information earlier and talked about the issues you were having. But let's take a look at 10 or so comments. So I'll sort this by oldest first and start from there. Getting good battery life on iPhone SE. Feels the same as the other updates. Don't think any of my bugs have really been fixed since it wasn't in the release notes. iPhone XS. Apple Music is still buggy in some aspects. Hopefully iOS 13.4 or iOS 14 will finally fix them. XS Max only problem so far is that when I play a YouTube video, there's another video's audio playing in the background. So I have two videos playing at the same time. Super annoying. Again, that's the comment I was saying that was having the same problem as me. Perfect so far on my iPhone XS. Using on my iPhone 7, it's great. Still some mail bugs. Showing new email, go into the mail app and no new emails are there. All good so far on my XR. Was having a problem with the activity app, but this update seems to have fixed it. It's been running great on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. Great battery life. I think this is where iOS 13 should have been from the beginning. I agree. Hopefully iOS 14 will be like that, just like iOS 12 was. I use iPhone 10. Everything goes well and battery is good, but still observe for a few days. So far, the update has been great. Battery seems to last longer on my iPhone SE, updated 2 days ago. The same seems to be true for the iPad Air 2, updated yesterday. Both run smoothly. Notice some Bluetooth connectivity problems with Sony headphones and iPhone SE, but not sure if this is caused by the iOS update. P.S. Love your videos. Thank you. Appreciate that. Using it on 7 Plus, seems that it prolonged the battery life. I honestly didn't notice anything different using 256GB 10S Max. Battery may be lasting a bit more, maybe. Does iPad OS count? Sure. I also count iPads as well. Battery drainage getting worse on my XR. iPhone 7, RAM management way better than before. Battery seems better too. Just updated from iOS 12.4.1. Seems to work fine. iPhone 10, iPad Air 2, best version of iOS 13 by far. Battery life is especially on the iPad great. iOS 13 is finally going in a good direction. Going good on my 11, still have some connectivity issues, but not as bad. Battery is a lot better on my XS Max. Before on iOS 13.3 and 13.3.1 betas, my battery capacity drained from 96 from 100%. I'm using an 8 Plus and no issues so far. iPhone XR, 100% battery health. My Wi-Fi and cellular connectivity is much better on iOS 13.3.1. Battery is incredible. My mail bug I had is even fixed. It is by far the most stable version of iOS 13 we have had so far. At long last, battery life finally improved on my iPhone 7. Hope Apple does not break it again. No issues on Pro Max. Running as smooth as ever. Battery life seems the same. I'm using iOS 13.3.1 on an iPhone 8 Plus. Everything is functioning excellently. No glitches or software stutters. XS Max, battery life has greatly improved. My only issues I've run into is the messages when I'm in landscape mode and go to portrait, the text is all pushed to the side and requires me to close the app and reopen it to get it correct. And also, when I get a text when I'm in another app and open it, the keys on the keyboard are all black. iPhone 6S, very smooth, no bugs or stutters, no multitasking issues, excellent battery backup. However, I'm getting a prompt to input my Apple ID password whenever I tap on Update All in the App Store. I don't get this prompt when I update the apps one by one. I've had some weird bugs like that too. If you just recently changed your password, it makes things a lot worse. So just make sure that it's updated as well as far as that goes on all of your devices. It's been running smooth on my iPhone 11. Camera seems to drain battery more than iOS 13.3. Other than that, everything seems okay so far. 11 Pro Max, RAM management is still struggling and Deep Fusion Photos takes a while to load when trying to edit the photo. This update was supposed to fix that and some people have said it's much faster. So I'm not sure what's going on. Maybe try a reboot and see if it fixes it. Running on iPhone 8 Plus, no problems, good speed, no app issues, no connectivity issues, I think is what you mean. It says conductivity, but connectivity. So far it's okay, but I do notice that my iPhone XS 128GB getting seriously warm when using LTE. It's something I haven't experienced before with this iPhone. Like I said earlier, try a reboot. That usually fixes that. iOS 13.3.1 is pretty good on my iPad Pro 2018 11-inch and iPhone 11 Pro Max, battery improved for me on 13.3.1. Enjoy all your videos. They're very detailed. Thank you. Appreciate that. Battery is terrific on my iPhone 11. A minor glitch where all inboxes did not work on my Series 3 Apple Watch has been fixed, but I don't know if that was the watch update or the phone update that fixed that. It's hard to say. That watch update had no notes and basically was just a security fix as far as what they said anyway. iPhone SE is here someone who still uses it and has problems with Wi-Fi working when the Bluetooth is turned on. Could I make a video about it? It's a major bug. Many people on the internet. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like to see a video about that. I do have an SE right here I could take a look at and see if I have that issue as well. And then finally, no complaints other than random freezes, black screen, and springboard restarts since I updated on a Pro Max. Again, try a reboot. That shouldn't be happening. So that's it for iOS 13.3.1. Hopefully it goes well and keeps getting better and better as time goes on. I would expect iOS 13.4 betas to start rolling out this coming week if Apple keeps as it's been doing for the past few years, and we'll see that and see maybe a couple new features and then see major changes in June with iOS 14. So I'm looking forward to that, but let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.